Howdy, and welcome to Write Right. In today's episode, we are featuring an interview with Dr. Robert Lane about writing in the field of engineering. Dr. Lane is a professor in the Department of Petroleum Engineering. He has 30 years' experience in the petroleum industry, working and consulting for international production companies. First, I asked Dr. Lane how important writing is in engineering. Here's what he had to say.
That's a really good question, and it's one that we don't usually think too much about while we're in school, but quite frankly, how important writing is to you in industry and in any technical field, especially in engineering, that depends on what you want to do in your job. If you're very content to stay in a back room just working on a very small piece of the action and not really going very far in your career, well, it's not so terribly important to be able to write well. But if you do want to move in your career, you have to be able to communicate clearly and succinctly, and get a message across to your management.
I then asked Dr. Lane what type of writing engineers are asked to do.
Well, they're seldom writing assignments per se, but you will have to do an analysis. Let's say in petroleum industry where I work, you may have an oil field that's got 1,000 wells in it, and 200 of those wells are closed or shut in for some problem that they have. You may do an analysis of those wells and determine that a certain number of them have similar types of problems. And there's no really surefire technology out there to fix all of those, but you've got some ideas that could be tried out by doing a pilot test on a few of those wells. And if it works, if the technology works there, it could fix all of those wells and increase the cash flow of your company by a huge amount of money. But in the petroleum industry and in a lot of other engineering industries, risk aversion is very important. They don't like to do things new. So if you want to do something new, you're going to have to very clearly study what has been done, very clearly point out how to get to the next step, what it's going to take to do that in the field, how much money it's going to cost, and what the probability of success is. And you need to be able to point that out, boom, 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 very clearly, very succinctly, or you're not going to be listened to.
Next, I asked Dr. Lane what percentage of his day was spent writing in industry.
I probably spent 50% of my time writing. And that I had one of the more fun jobs. I was in field operations engineering. I was going out in the field. You know, I was spending a quarter to a third of my time actually in the field, looking over the shoulder of the people who are actually turning the valves and pumping the pumps. Now, if I'm in planning, where I'm developing, say, the five-year plan for a project, in my case, the project would be in oil field management, but it might be a plant design or plant maintenance schedule or whatever for some other type of engineer, then if I'm in the planning aspects of things, I'm writing all the time. That's what I do. I'm looking up information, crunching numbers, and writing it up. And that's what I'm doing all the time. You'll do a lot higher percentage of your time will be spent writing in industry than it is here at the university.
I then asked Dr. Lane how writing skills affect success in the engineering industry.
What was a shock for me, I'd been pure academic before I went into industry. And the thing that was a shock to me is that, yes, we're all working for the same company, and yes, you'd think we all have the same goal, but by golly, we're all competing with each other for attention from above. And those who win in that competition for attention from above are the ones who are going to go places. And being able to get that attention from above is going to depend as much on your communication skills as it will on your technical skills. That was a big shock to me. I'm competing with my compatriots, and how well I communicate is just as important, if not more so eventually, than my technical abilities.
Next, I asked Dr. Lane if engineers must write differently for different audiences.
If it's for your immediate supervisor, you can be a little more in the technical detail, a little less maybe in the economics, a little more explanation, because you really want him or her to understand the technical aspects of things. But as you go a level up from that, as you help him or her develop a presentation or a report for higher management, you get a little bit further away from detail and the technical aspects of the problem and look a little bit more at the economic impacts and implications of it. And this will slide more in that direction the higher up you go in the organization. We make jokes of that, of course, that, you know, the higher up the person in the organization, the shorter their attention span. And the reason for that is they have to make lots of decisions. They have to, and they have to do them quickly on just the important detail of the data, the take-home message. They have to make that decision. They've got to have confidence in you that you're giving them the right stuff so that they don't have to worry about what the information they're getting is, whether it's correct or not. It needs to be correct, and then they have to make the decision, okay, based on our plan for the next period of time, we have to make a decision this way on that particular item.
Then I asked Dr. Lane how important oral communication is in engineering.
Initially, as a starting engineer, you're probably going to do more writing, and your supervisor is going to do the presenting, the oral presentation. That supervisor's got to have confidence in what you've done in order to present it soundly. But once you start having some successes, you'll get your turn to present, and again, you have got to do it very clearly, very succinctly, very concisely, very quickly, because you're going to be talking to people at higher levels, and their attention span is not nearly as long as yours is.
Next, I asked Dr. Lane what type of writing issues he felt students struggle with the most.
I don't know how much struggle, they probably don't do enough struggling with, but getting grammar, correct grammar, is very important. Learning to write in the first person as opposed to the passive tense, which is causes me and a lot of other people to just climb the walls. It was observed that, we saw this, we observed this. You can write a lot more succinctly in the first person, and clearly short sentences, clear impact sentences, get your message into the first sentence and then flesh out the rest of the paragraph with the detail.
Then I asked Dr. Lane what advice he has for students who hate writing and want to avoid it.
And if you want to be a Dilbert and stay back in your little cubicle with your tie turned up for the rest of your life, that's the way to think. But if you, and at this point in the game, you may think that is all you want to do. But I'll guarantee you, you're closing doors on yourself if you take that attitude and you don't put effort into learning to write. I hate writing now. I hate creating from the get-go with a blank page. It's great that I have graduate students whose writing I can take and edit. It's a lot easier to do that. And of course, as you move up in an organization, the more your writing becomes editing and helping out your underlings, which is another reason for wanting to write well and be able to move up in the organization so you don't have to create it from scratch. It's the creating from scratch part that's difficult. We all hate it. It's one of the hardest things we do.
Next, I asked Dr. Lane if he had any tips for students to improve their writing and speaking skills.
Spend as much time as you can up in front of an audience speaking and learning how to speak clearly, and don't moan and begroan when you have to do your capstone projects and you have to write reports and lab reports and these kinds of things, and take every opportunity you can to get up in front of a group and speak.
Then I asked Dr. Lane if he had any final thoughts on writing and engineering.
I'm maybe overstating the case a little bit here, but it's basically, I don't think we as engineers realize how important writing is to us when we get into it. We've got to document what we've done for the future. And we want to move up in our career. We want to be recognized for what we have done, get rewarded for that. And if we cannot communicate it well, both written and oral communication, then it's you can't do it.
Well, that concludes our interview with Dr. Robert Lane on writing and engineering. Thanks for listening to this episode of Write Right. We'll see you next time.